This is what the sun really looks like. The surface is dynamic, lots of sunspots, lots of filaments, and plenty of prominences. This is very different from using a white light filter. A dedicated hydrogen alpha telescope is not cheap, but for me, after having used a white light filter for more than 12 years, it was really worth the upgrade. My only regret is I wish I bought this years earlier. So stay tuned for a ton of information on the Lunt 40 dedicated hydrogen alpha telescope, as well as my first light review of this scope. The image you saw is far from the best shot of the sun, but it's the first image that I captured with my Lunt 40 and I'm really happy with it. I recently took delivery of the Lunt 40 telescope, and in this video, I'll quickly go over the telescope and its specs, why I chose the Lunt 40 over the Lunt 50, why I chose a Lunt over a Daystar Quark, and then we'll take a quick look at my setup outside, and finally, we'll go over the images of the sun I took with my phone, a DSLR, and a guide camera. In this video, I'll use certain terms such as Etalon and tuning and angstrom. I won't go deep into what any of those means. I'll save that for a future video. I'll also really just skim over my capture and processing steps of the sun. I'll also save that for a future video, hopefully during my second light with my telescope. So let's quickly go over the telescope specs. So the Lunt 40 is a dedicated hydrogen alpha telescope. And what that means is that it lets a very narrow wavelength of light through to the eyepiece or camera sensor. That wavelength of light is 656.28 nanometers. Very specific. It has a 40 millimeter aperture with 400 millimeters of focal length, which makes it an F10 telescope. It tunes the Etalon using tilt shift. And on a single stack, you can get less than 0.7 angstroms. And with a double stack, you can get less than 0.5 angstroms. It comes with a helical focuser, but you can add a feather touch focuser as an additional item. They currently don't allow you to choose one or the other. You get the helical focuser, and you can add on a feather touch, which will be delivered to you at a later date. This telescope is super light. It's only a little over 2.5 pounds, or 1.16 kilograms. And this includes with the dovetail, the diagonal, and the sole searcher, which is incredibly light. The blocking filter size options that you have are 5mm, 6mm, and 12mm in diagonal format, and the solar image size is about 4mm. I ended up getting the 6mm blocking filter just so that I could have extra room around the sun, so that if I ever use a Barlow lens, I have more of the sun in my view. And the respective prices are, based on the filter size, $749, $857, and $1,203. So I ended up paying $857. One of the questions I've already been asked by someone who I've had a conversation with about the Lunt telescopes is, why did I get a Lunt 40 instead of a Lunt 50? And spoiler alert, it had to do with me wanting to save as much money as possible. So the Lunt 50 is a pressure tuning system, and the Lunt 40 is a tilt tuning system. Pressure tuning is new, and as far as I know, as far as anyone knows, there is absolutely no difference in the quality of resolution and contrast of the sun between the two. So that wasn't a factor. When you order the Lunt 50, you only have two options for blocking filters, and that's 4mm and the 6mm. Although in the Lunt 50 the sun would look a little bit smaller, I felt that the 4mm would have been too small, so if I were to order the Lunt 50, I would have gone with the 6mm to give me some extra space. And the respective prices, based on the blocking filter sizes, is $957 and $1,011. The Lunt 50 is a 50mm aperture with a 350mm focal length, making it an F7 telescope. It's a little bit faster, but I think when it comes to the sun, that really doesn't matter. The Lunt 40 actually comes with a couple of accessories the Lunt 50 doesn't, which actually adds on to the cost of the Lunt 50. And the first one is the dovetail bar. So the Lunt 40 comes with a really nice dovetail bar that you can add on from Lunt for $44 to $49. You can of course always get your own and add that on, but that's always an additional cost. So this is missing from the Lunt 50. But it does come with a clamshell so that you can add on your own dovetail bar easily. The next thing it's missing is that it does not come with a TeleVue sole searcher. This is my favorite part of this telescope because it makes finding the sun so easy, and I think I might end up getting another one for my white light filter setup just because it just saves me so much time. So we'll see this in action soon, and you'll see exactly why I love it. So the TeleVue sole searcher is another $44. On the Lunt website from other stores, it's about $45. So that adds to the cost of the Lunt 50. The Lunt 40 with the B600 filter, the 6mm size filter, is $243 less than the Lunt 50 if you take the dovetail and the TeleVue sole searcher into account. And becoming a new parent recently, saving as much money as possible was the number one factor as to why I did not get the Lunt 50. $243 isn't a lot in the grand scheme of how much these telescopes cost, but it was enough to convince me to go with the Lunt 40 instead. So the next question is, why did I go with the Lunt 40 instead of a Daystar Quark? So I'll add some points as to why the Daystar Quark could be better than a Lunt. So first, you can turn any refractor from F4 to an F8 to a dedicated hydrogen alpha telescope, which is pretty cool. It has a built-in 4.2x Barlow. Another great thing about the Daystar Quark is that it comes with a 12mm blocking filter, twice the size of the blocking filter that I have on my Lunt 40, and they claim that you can see a full disk of the sun on up to 450mm focal length telescope, which is really cool. Now let's go over the few reasons why I didn't get it. So the first thing is, it needs power. It needs 5 volts, 1.5 amp power. It's easy enough to do with a power bank, just plug it in, but it's just another wire, which makes it far less plug and play. And every time you tune the Daystar Quark, you have to wait 5 to 10 minutes for the temperature to equalize. If I have to wait 5 to 10 minutes every time I retune this thing, if I tune it twice, you know, my lunch break is gone and then I have to go back inside. So that's a huge no-no for me, one of the biggest reasons why I didn't get it. And the third thing is, the cost of a Daystar Quark is almost $1,300. A few hundred dollars more than the Lunt 50. So if I wasn't gonna get the Lunt 50 for like $1,100, I was definitely not gonna go with the Daystar Quark. All right, let's take a look at the telescope itself now. So here's the Lunt 40 on one of my mounts, and in the front here is where we have the Etalon. You can see it has like a pinkish glow, and this is what does the magic of allowing us to see the sun in hydrogen alpha. You can actually double stack this. It's very new for the Lunt 40, so you can add another one of these Etalons in front of this, and you can get an even sharper and more contrasty image of the sun. And on the right side here, you'll see that there's a knob here to do the tilt tuning. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. So I'm going to turn this to the side. So that's refocused and zoomed in, and you'll see that when I turn this, you'll see here that the gap between the telescope and the Etalon starts to increase. So I'm going to start turning it, and you can see that you can start to see the wall behind me, and you can see that there is a tilt. So the tilt is used to change the angle at which the light from the sun hits the front of the telescope, and it can change the resolution and the contrast. So depending on your seeing and your equipment, you may need to do a tilt shift to make sure that you can see the sun as sharp as possible. So we can look at the telescope here. It has a really nice finish. It feels heavy, but it's very light. As we saw earlier, it's only about 2.5 pounds. Next, we'll look at the helical focuser here. It's okay, but of course, every time I focus, I shift the image a tiny bit, and then I have to repoint my mount. I'm hoping to upgrade this to a feather touch mount sometime in the future. It does come with a locking screw here, so that's one of the things that Lunt includes with the telescope. And then let's take a look at the diagonal, which is the B600 hydrogen alpha blocking filter in a diagonal format. I'm going to take this out and we'll take a closer look at what it looks like. So this is a B600 hydrogen alpha filter, and what the 600 is just 6 millimeters. And it has a 1.25 inch tube, which is standard for most telescopes, for most eyepieces. And if you look here, you can see that there is a little bluish glass that in the front of the diagonal that lets the sunlight through. And this is the front part of it. It's much larger than the other side, which is here. So I'm going to take this out, and then we can see that here there's a much smaller circle, and this is the 6 millimeter width or diameter part of the diagonal that lets me see with my eyepiece or my camera. So if I were to get a B1200, it would be twice as big, and B400 would be a little bit smaller, about 33% to be precise. And the Etalon and this together lets us see the sun in hydrogen alpha. And one of the cool things about this is that this comes with T2 threads. So if you're using a camera with T2 threads, you can just screw it on here without having to use any other kind of tube here. This also comes off. So if you need additional, if you need to get closer to the focal point here, if your focal point, you know, you're not reaching focus, you need to go farther in than farther out. You can take this off and then you can screw it in here as well. So, but I won't take that off. It's nice. And to me, it feels like this is the heaviest part of the telescope. It's pretty thick. And in the bottom, we have the Made in USA. So I'm going to put this back. And on top of this, we have my favorite accessory, the TeleVue Soul Searcher. It is awesome. There's a little hole in the front here that lets the sunlight through, and it projects the sun in the back here. It's probably not in great focus, but we'll take a closer look at it soon. There's a little place where the sun projects onto it, and near the center is where the center of the actual telescope is, is where the view of the sun would be. So you just need to center it in the TeleVue Soul Searcher, super easy, and then you can look at the sun. So there's just a quick overview of the telescope, weighs 2.5 pounds, so let's take a look at what it looks like outside. I set up my Lunt 40 on my AVX mount in my driveway with a really rough balance and alignment. I actually had an issue balancing it because the telescope is so light. Then I used my hand controller to point it towards the sun. And this is where the TeleVue Soul Searcher came in very handy. You can see the sun being projected onto the back of the Soul Searcher here. And then I used my hand controller to make small adjustments until the sun is directly in the center of the little white projection screen. I discovered that the sun in view is slightly off-center, which I believe can be corrected by adjusting the hex screws on the TeleVue Soul Searcher. I then looked through the eyepiece and make further adjustments to center the sun and focus. The Soul Searcher allowed me to get going in less than a minute. I saw a very red sun with some small prominences sticking out of the sun, and I was really happy with it. So the quickest way to take a picture was with my phone, so I used a phone adapter and tried it out. The gap between the eyepiece and the phone adapter made the image look really smudgy. It's not an issue during the night when it's dark, but during the day it's noticeable. The phone was very well captured how the sun looked through the eyepiece, including some prominences that I was able to see. Here's a better look at a single image of the sun with the phone. You can see lots of sunspots and a pretty large prominence at the bottom. Amazing! I then used the built-in T-threads in the blocking filter diagonal and screwed in the T5i DSLR for a picture. After some struggles with focusing, I was able to get this single image of the sun. It's super red, not much surface details. But I did do a quick lucky imaging session and was able to get this as a result of stacking and wavelets. Again, not great, but not the worst. We can see prominences and surface details. Finally, I took out my ZWO ASI 120mm mini guide cam with a tiny sensor, so it's not able to fit the entire sun in view. But the result was amazing. This is the first monochrome shot of the sun, and it looked great. After taking about 1,000 frames, I did a quick stack in AutoStacker 3, saved the sharpened file, and colorized it in Photoshop, and ended up with this result. This image of the sun is just a different variation of the colorization. And we can see clear details on the sun, including sunspots and prominences. Future plans include playing with the capture settings, compositing, mosaics, and I may also invest in a new monocam with a bigger sensor.
I plan on streaming the partial solar eclipse that will be visible all throughout North America on October 14, 2023. It'll be a partial eclipse from where I am because I will not be able to travel to a location where annularity will be visible. So come back for that stream, and hopefully by then I will have figured everything out. Links to all the Lunt products that I mentioned are in the description below. They are affiliate links. You don't have to use them, but I would greatly appreciate it if you would. I'm hoping that in the next video, I'm able to do a second session with my Lunt 40 so that I can record my capture and processing steps of how I captured the sun. The Lunt is very expensive, so the alternative is to do a white light filter, and I do have a video on how to create your own for just a couple of bucks. Link to that in the description below as well, so be sure to check that out. And for the upcoming eclipses and to also just any time viewing of the sun, make sure you use proper eye protection and get yourself some eclipse glasses. It's better to get them sooner rather than later because I am noticing that the prices of these glasses are going up and up. I'll link to the reputable sources in the description below as well. If you have any questions about anything I cover or you want to see something about the Lunt 40 that I didn't cover, please ask in the comments below. I'm more than happy to take a look. Thank you for watching. Until next time, clear skies.